Now, it's tempting to think golf's a nice, safe sport, certainly compared to doing this, but Fabrizio Zanotti discovered otherwise at the KLM Open when he was sent reeling by a fellow competitor's wayward drive. He was in good spirits, though, when we caught up with him recently and reflected on his journey to the European Tour from his home in Paraguay.
We used to have like 6 Challenge Tour events in all Latin America, so that was that makes us a little easier to come here. I won in the Mexican Open, and that was a big help for me because then I get my car for the Challenge Tour, and I play all 2007 in the Challenge Tour, and I get my tour car there.
His rookie season on the European Tour was a struggle, and Fabrizio finished way down the order of merit, meaning an end-of-season trip to the qualifying school.
Well, you never want to play Q School. Q School is probably the worst tournament for a golf pro, I think. I just was having a half a tough year in the main tour, but I think it was more because it was my first year and I was getting used to the golf course.
He successfully navigated Q School and things took an upward trend over the next few years as he started to establish himself on the European Tour. He had several near misses, finishing second 3 times in 4 seasons before swing problems saw him back at Q School in 2013. A second place finish at PGA Catalunya earned him an immediate return, and in June this year he finally got his breakthrough win at the BMW International Open. After posting at 19 under, he then had to wait as world number 3 Henrik Stenson had a putt for victory.
When he missed it, I just go to the range, hit some balls, and I was very calm.
Zanotti and Stenson were joined by Spain's Rafael Cabrera-Bello and Frenchman Gregory Havre in a 4-man playoff in Cologne.
When I get to the 18th tee, and I just say, enjoy every single shot you're making, and I think that was a very important thing for me in that playoff.
Havre was first to go, then Cabrera-Bello. Zanotti kept himself in it with a gutsy putt.
I think that when I hold that putt, I take all the pressure that I have and I say, come on, I'm here, let's do it.
On the 5th extra hole, Stenson unexpectedly pushed his tee shot and found the water hazard. With Fabrizio safely on the green, the Swede conceded and handed the Paraguayan his first European Tour victory.
Everything was a little fast because he conceded the hole, and then it was my caddy, then came my wife, it came the friends, and they throw me all the champagne, and it was like a confused moment for me. It was like, I was very happy, I was feeling very good things.
The victory elevated him to heady heights over the summer, earning him starts at both the WGC Bridgestone Invitational and the USPGA Championship. But what, we wondered, did he make of his first go at indoor skydiving?
It was very tough at the beginning. I mean, it was tough all the time, but it was a great feeling. It would just feel really good going up there. It was really good.
Having tasted the high life, don't be surprised if Fabrizio soars once more when he makes his return to the golf course.